the government should have been prepared for second wave. Lack of preparedness is apparent.
We can't expect that the solution to the COVID crisis can completely come from the judiciary. That burden should not be put on judiciary.
It is not the work of judiciary. It is not the work of judiciary. It is essentially the work of the government executive.
How do you view the preparedness of the government for COVID-19?
But so far as government is concerned, they are always having expert opinion with them. So I think the government should have been prepared for second wave. Lack of preparedness is apparent. After going through the orders, fortunately, I have seen all the orders passed by the COVID bench so far. And I found that the orders are well-reasoned.
But sir, what about the consequences we are seeing of the panchayat boards? Considering the rising death toll of the teachers who were made to participate in panchayat board, where does the buck lie?
Neither the protocol nor the directions given by the High Court were followed. If those directions and protocol would have been adhered by the state government, I think this unfortunate incidents would have not happened.
Why isn't the state government being held accountable? Why don't we see any officer of the state government or a minister of a state government facing the wrath of the law?
Court can invoke contempt jurisdiction. Contempt proceedings be initiated under Contempt of Courts Act 1971 as well as under Article 215 of the Constitution. So it can be done.
So my question is that why it has not been done so far? What is the threshold? What is the threshold that needs to be met for?
Who are having personal cause, they may go for compensation also. They may for initiating criminal proceedings against individuals also. There are so many aspects. All are required to be taken into consideration. And so far as compensation part is concerned, I think this is an important aspect. And persons affected, they must think about having compensation. With regard to public at large is concerned, we are in a democratic setup. It is the people must aware themselves of how the work has been done. Certain things are required to be settled in a political manner also. And politics is a positive thing. The entire country runs through our policies. So something are required to be answered politically, not by the judicial fora only.
During the COVID benches, as you mentioned, across the country in high courts, gave us some very interesting commentary. You have the Madras High Court saying that officers of the Election Commission should be charged with murder. You had the Delhi High Court saying that, you know, people, officers who are being negligent should be hanged. So we saw certain very, very strong commentary coming from high courts across the country. But these were oral observations and did not make part of the actual orders. How do you see high courts making such strong commentary and them these words becoming part of news?
It is quite obvious that the court, as well as lawyers, may make certain comments. That is because of this, during the course of heated arguments, it is quite natural, quite obvious. But ultimately, we are required to see the order passed by the court. It is not these observations or comments. These are quite obvious. There's nothing new in it. This is only now the things are that now press is reporting these comments. Otherwise, I have seen, I'm having experience of about 35 years or little more than that.
But the Election Commission took it very seriously. Election Commission moved the Supreme Court.
This is, you see, the Election Commission, instead of looking into the order passed by the court, considered it appropriate to go through the news items appeared in different newspapers or electronic media, whatever it may be. I don't know why they have taken this issue so seriously. Otherwise, it is quite obvious in courts when 4 persons or 10 persons are discussing something, two parties are arguing different issues, then such kind of comments are quite obvious.
So we can't expect that the solution to the COVID crisis can completely come from the judiciary. That burden should not be put on judiciary.
It is not the work of judiciary. It is not the work of judiciary. It is essentially the work of the government executive, not of judiciary. Judiciary is coming only where somebody is approaching or not approaching, where it is some violation of constitutional provision or a legal right is apparent. Otherwise, not.
So your own illustrious career in the Allahabad High Court saw some cases where you took the state government head on and you held the state government accountable for the violations of civil liberties. So when you were hearing those cases, for instance, the AMU violence case or the name and shame banners of anti-CAA protesters, did you receive any informal, formal pushback for holding the government accountable?
Never. No one ever approached me directly, indirectly, or otherwise. I tell you, in my entire career as a judge of 17 years, I never received or nobody made any kind of such such thing to pursue me. I say, so far as judges are concerned, mostly they are not having any kind of pressure. They are working independently.
The Allahabad High Court is recently observed that the medical facilities in the Uttar Pradesh is not up to the mark, especially in the rural areas. And now we are also facing the threat of a third virus or a third wave. What do you think the next course of action would be for the Allahabad High Court in the anticipated crises of the COVID-19?
First, if court has said so, then it must be based on the material available with it. And when the court has entered into this issue, then court is supposed to look into what kind of facilities be given in rural areas, how functioning of hospitals be improved, and all other ancillary matters. But you see, ultimately, it is for the state government to take necessary steps, and as soon as possible steps are to be taken, court can certainly issue certain directions, guide the state government